Hi, I am Valder Beebe. I am the host and the visionary of That Celebrity Interview.
Thank you so much for joining me here live in Dallas, Texas, as I broadcast across the nation on an FM platform. And you're here to talk about getting back in the dating game.
I am.
Okay. What kind of insider information can you give us about that crazy world?
All right, so I'm the founder of a dating app called Lumen, which is especially for over 50s. And I guess one of the main things that I noticed is that if you are in your 50s or 60s, then perhaps you haven't dated for some time, and it can seem a little bit scary. Don't be daunted. It is fun. We actually have features. If you're a little bit worried about dating, we actually have some features where you can just make friends on the app. We have a group chat function where you can talk about travel, and you can talk about food and sport and just kind of test the water before you actually try dating, which I think is quite nice. But we've got loads and loads of dating advice on our website, and we've really tried to create a space where people feel safe and encouraged to try dating again.
Well, my audience should know that Charlie is the co-founder and CMO of Luminant. Okay, so you're talking about the dating app, first of all. What if you don't know how to use an app, Charlie? Let's back up a bit.
Well, so actually we have a YouTube channel where I show everyone how to log on, so don't panic if you're worrying about using the app. And actually both myself and my co-founder have profiles on the app so people can ask us questions. And I get hundreds of messages every day from people asking me which pictures do you think I should use, or where a certain button is, or even just telling me about the date that they're going on that night, which is really cool.
Why do you see a need for an app like a dating for people over 50? Can't they find their own date?
Well, I think everyone is dating online these days. If you look at it, actually more than 50% of couples these days are formed online. So it seems a shame that people in their 50s and 60s can't benefit from that. Now, there were dating sites out there for this age group before, but I think the majority of them treat people in the 50s and 60s like they're a lot older than they actually are. And in reality, most of the people I know who are 50 or 60 date in a very similar way to people in their 30s or 40s. They want to use apps, they're tech savvy, they use their smartphones for everything else in life, so why not use it for dating? And the thing is that while there are dating apps out there which say they're for everyone, in reality they were designed for millennials. And actually there are some big issues with that. Like for a start, some of the apps you couldn't even join if you were over 50. You used to have to lie about your age. And some of them, they group you in just in one pool if you're over 55. You don't even really have an age on the app. And one of the experiences that a lot of women complained about actually on the more mainstream apps is that because men can talk to anyone, quite often the women in their 50s and 60s actually feel ignored by men their own age because they're trying to date younger women. So by creating a space where you know everyone on Lumen is interested in dating another over 50, we wanted to create a safe place as possible. We photo verify every single member, and we try and encourage the best communication possible. We've got some really cool features to encourage better communication on the app.
Okay, regular dating is a little challenging. So give us some dating tips because you say we're over 50, we're dating, and a lot of people have lost their spouse, gone through a divorce, living alone for a long time. All of those are almost unique circumstances. So what are some of the dating maneuvers that we need to know about?
Okay. So I think if you haven't dated for a long time, or if you've never dated before, if you've come out of a long-term relationship, try not to just look for the same person that you used to date. I think try and keep quite an open mind. I think remember that it is a numbers game and just try and chat to as many people as you can. If you get a vibe that you like someone over messaging, I would try and meet up quite quickly. I think you only realize if there's a spark when you meet them in person. And just remember to meet in a public place and keep your wits about you. You are meeting a stranger. But take it step by step. In terms of dating profiles, I think one of the biggest mistakes that over 50s make is you've got 50 or 60 years of photos of yourself. So even if you have the best picture of you ever, if it's more than a few years old, don't put it on your dating profile, because in reality, you want to turn up on the date looking like the person on your dating profile. So if you don't own the clothes you're wearing in that photo, or they don't fit you anymore, then maybe leave it off your dating profile. And I think honesty really is the best piece of advice you can have for dating, regardless of what age you are. Be honest. Be honest about who you are. If you need help with your dating profile, maybe get a friend who's a little bit honest and brutal to tell you, do you know what? That doesn't sound like you, or those pictures don't look like you. I think that honesty is really important, because in reality, you want to meet someone who's compatible with you. And if you pretend to be someone else, then you're not going to meet that person with that compatibility.
All right. Before I wrap up, I'd like to know, what do you think are the assets of this group we're talking about? And this group is considered in America, we call them the baby boomer group. What's the best asset that they can highlight in their profile?
I think just be honest. I think everyone's different. I think just talk to a friend about the things that they, the ways that they would describe you. I think the pitfalls that people come across is by trying to describe their ideal self. So if you have like a gym membership that you never use, don't put that on your dating profile, right? Be as honest as possible. If family's important to you, then you can say that. And a lot of people will include pictures of their family on their profile to show that that's something that's important to them. But I think, yeah, just being honest with yourself and taking it step by step, right? Dating can be a long process. It's not just a case of signing up and meeting your future husband or wife tomorrow. That's not the case, right? Imagine, you know, take your time, really enjoy the process, go and learn some stuff about you, go on some cool dates, and you just never know where it'll go.
All right. Well, you kind of blew my next question from Facebook. The poster wants to know, he's looking for a wife and he doesn't want to spend a long time. So can you just post, I'm looking for a wife?
Well, you can definitely say that that's what you're looking for. We actually have a section on Lumen which says, I'm looking for. And I always recommend that people write the relationship they're looking for, not the person. I think one of the biggest mistakes that people make on dating profiles, actually, is by being really negative. I think if you say, I only want to date a woman who's a size zero and blonde or whatever, or I don't want to date this, what you end up doing is putting off everyone, not just the people you want to put off, you end up putting off the people you want to date too. So try and be as positive as possible. But yeah, talk about the relationship that you want. I think, but just remember that it is, you know, it's not an immediate process. There is some time that you need to devote to it. And, you know, you need to go back on regularly. You need to chat to lots of people. Remember that people use their smartphones in different ways. So if you message someone and they don't reply within a few minutes, don't panic. Some people might take 2 or 3 days to check their phone. And don't worry if you're talking to multiple people at once at the start, because that is the new way of dating. Quite a lot of people are messaging lots of different people. And then when it comes to meeting up, then you can decide about who you want to meet up with and whether you want to meet one person at a time.
All right, Charlie Lester, I'm going to take this final question. They want to know, how come you know so much about creating this dating app?
Well, so I've worked in the dating industry for over 6 years. I actually used to run the industry awards, and part of that job was I used to literally judge all of the dating apps and dating sites that were out there. So I literally, you know, 3 times a year I'd be judging the apps in America, in Europe, and in the UK. And so I learned so much about dating apps and dating sites and the things that work and the things that don't. I also have been single and used dating apps myself, and I think that makes a big difference. I think if you look at a lot of the dating sites, that the old dating sites that are out there, they were created by people who weren't even single. They were married. They'd never used these services. And I think it's really important. My co-founder actually met his wife on a dating app. So the two of us know a lot about dating apps.
All right then, Charla Lester. And where do you want my audience to go to get more information about this dating app?
So you can download Lumen from the App Store. You just type in L-U-M-E-N and it should come up. Or if you want more info, you can go to our website, which is www.lumenapp.com. That's L-U-M-E-N-A-P-P.
Well, Charla Lester, this has been a very engaging conversation. I hope my audience enjoyed it as much as I did. And thanks for being my guest on the Velder Beebe Show.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Velder Beebe. I host the Velder Beebe Show, broadcast on radio and television. And this is my phone pouch. My phone pouch is a great invention. It allows me to go hands-free, pocket-free, purse-free, even belt-free. Head on over to myphonepouch.com.